everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new to my channel, then hey, my name is Saili Viswas. So today in this video, I'm gonna show this wonderful blue smoky eye look in detail. So if you're interested to know that how I created this beautiful, magical and flawless look, then definitely keep on watching. And also don't forget to give this video a very big thumbs up. And also if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, then please do it right now. So now finally, let's begin our makeup. So before getting into the makeup, let's do some skincare. And also let me say you that I'm obsessed with skincare. At first, I'm spraying toner all over my face and pat little bit. And thereafter, I'm applying Pond's Light Moisturizer all over my face and neck. And I will massage a bit in order to improve my blood circulation. So now let's do the brow first, because whenever I want the colors to pop up, I like to start my makeup doing the brows first and then followed by the eye makeup. So here I'm filling in the gaps using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Eyebrow Pomade, and then I will blend and slightly brush it using a pulley. And then I will clean the brows using a very light concealer, which is from Too Faced, in order to get a sharp and defined brows. I love doing this step when I do bright colored eyes. And also let me say you that detail of all the product and the shade number will be given in the description box. So definitely do not worry about it. So okay, now using the same concealer, which is 2 or 3 shades lighter than my actual skin tone, I'm going to apply it a little bit on my eyelids in order to prepare it for the base, and then I will blend it using a concealer brush, and thereafter I will set it using a loose powder, which is from Maybelline Fit Me. So finally, let's get started with the eye makeup. So here I'm using a black kajal from Huda Beauty. You can use any black kajal, but make sure that's not super dry or matte, or else it will be really difficult for you to blend. And as you can see that I applied some on my eyelid till the crease line. You do not have to be perfect or precise, as you're going to blend it right now using a brush. Then for today's look, I grabbed my favorite eyeshadow palette from Tan Beauty, which I discovered from an Instagram page. So here I picked up a black shadow, which is named as Coal, and I will pat it gently on the eyes first, and then I will blend it around the edges to get rid of any kind of harsh lines. So let me mention that this palette is a bit on pricier side, but do not worry about it, as you can achieve this look from any palette containing blue and black shade. So moving on, I picked up a nude shade which is named as Blower Kiss, and I will blend it above the crease line in order to get a seamless and soft finish. So now let's move on to the magical part. So here I will pick up 2 shades, that is one blue shade which is named as Kamikaze, I hope that's how we pronounce, and another shade is an emerald shade which is named as Hoo Ha. And I will pick up the shades using my fingers, and I will press it very properly on the places where I apply the black kajal. If you want, then definitely you can use a flat brush and spray some fixer on it and then apply it. But for me, fingers works the best when it comes to the application of shimmers and glitters. So now let's do the face makeup, and then later on again we will come back to the eyes. So at first I will apply a primer all over my face for smooth foundation application, and it will also help to blur out any kind of pores on my skin. Next I will apply a foundation, and this is from Huda Beauty. I will dot the foundation all over my face and neck, and I will blend it using a brush. And then using a damp beauty sponge, I will just run all over my face in order to achieve that seamless and smooth kind of finish. So now it's time to conceal and brighten up my face. Here I'm applying it near the inner corner of my eyes and outer corner to get a sort of wing and lifted kind of effect. And then I will apply it in other areas such as forehead, then the bridge of the nose and chin. Today I want to do a little bit of baking using a banana powder from Makeup Revolution. So let me mention few benefits of baking, like what happens if you'll do baking. So baking will help to avoid the base from cracking or creasing, which happens most of the time, and it will also help the makeup stay longer as comparatively, and it will also give us a smooth finish and smooth base. Now very quickly, I will bronze up my face using the Hoola bronzer from Benefit. Bronzing will help to get back some warmth on my face, and it will also prevent that washed out face which looks very bad and awkward sometimes. And then I will even apply blush on cheeks and even on nose, because I like that rosy and soft effect. And this is the blush from Color Bar, and let me say that it's my current favorite. Then for the highlighter, here is the MAC Extra Skin Finish Highlighter. I will take some amount to the brush and add some shine and glow to the skin. And then I will sweep to the targeted area, such as the cheekbone, then down to the bridge of the nose, forehead, chin, and lastly to the brow bone and inner corner of the eyes. So now getting back to the eyes. So for today's look, I thought of drawing a very small wing eyeliner, and here I'm using the Maybelline Colossal Liquid Liner. And now coming to the lower lash line, first and foremost, I will apply some black kajal on the waterline, and then using a smudging brush, I will smudge and smoke out a bit. And also let me say you that I will be following the same steps as I did on the upper eyes. And then I will pick the blue and emerald shade and pat it gently on top of the black kajal. And then using a shade or a nude shade, I will blend the color just below the kajal. And to make my eyes look bigger and attractive, I will glide on the white kajal from Color Bar on the lower waterline. And lastly, to add some length and volume to my natural lashes, I will coat it twice using the Huda Beauty Legit Lashes Mascara. And of course, this look is absolutely incomplete if I don't wear falsies. So here is my favorite falsies from Kingdom of Lashes, and I will wear it with the help of the pack glue. So let me say that it's not possible to teach how to wear falsies in this way or in one video. So if you want to learn it or want me to make a separate video, then definitely mention it in the comment section. So ta-da! Just see how a simple false lash completely changed and added spice to the entire look. So now I'm thinking, which lipstick shade should I wear today? And finally I decided to apply a nude shade, as my eye is too dramatic. So this is a very beautiful matte lipstick again from Huda Beauty, and it's one of my favorite nude pink shade. It's smudge proof and lasts really long. And yeah, that's it. This is the final look. I really love the way this makeup turned out. And also let me mention that I'm not a professional makeup artist. I just do it out of my passion, and doing makeup always makes me very happy. If you like this look, don't forget to give it a very big thumbs up. And definitely don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel to see more such videos. Bye and take care until I meet you again in next video.